coro. Agogo coro. Agogo coro. Agogo coro. Bari bari. Introduce it. What's poppin', beautiful people? Today I have my mother on the channel, and today we're going to be talking about what, mommy? Tell them the name of it.
Situations.
But what is the word called? It's a relationship, but it's a what?
But not a relationship.
So what's the name of the relationship that's not a relationship?
Situationship.
Yes, good. You said situation, that's why I wanted you to say situationship.
Oh.
Mommy.
Bossy.
Mommy be regular.
I am regular. Oh, I can be medium.
Didn't I just ask?
No, not serious.
Oh my god. Okay. So. Can you stop laughing? All right.
Hi, my name is Lindsay's mom. And on Thursday, I was going to work.
All right, just talk like you're talking to me.
I thought you wanted me to talk regular.
Like, mommy.
I'm talking regular. Yeah, right. Yes, you just assimilate.
Okay.
Oh, it's part of it. You all listen to it.
All
right. Thursday, I was going to work. I was in the car listening to 104.1. And there was something they were talking about, and it was really interesting. So I was listening all the way to work. Some people that are in situationship. Like, it was really, I'm like, huh. I've heard about so many of them, but it's like it was so, people were calling in from so many places. So I came home and I was talking to Lindsay. I said, Lindsay, listen to what I was hearing when I was going to work. And she was like, yeah, mommy, they have situationship and what else? Something ship. And I'm like, oh, okay. So she was, but then there was one that really, really touched me, that there was this girl called Jessica who have to relocate. And
she relocated, y'all, because of a guy, because of her situationship. Okay, continue.
So she was in this situationship with a guy, which she was thinking it was a relation that
so
was.
So she thought
out.
That they were in a relationship.
Yes,
but they.
But
weren't.
With her, with a guy, they were not.
But
with a girl,
mind.
In her mind, something was going on because. Okay. The guy really likes her. The guy can call her midnight. They can stay on the phone. The guy will complain about something. They will cry together. They will go out together. And sometimes the guy will make a comment like, oh my gosh, you are the only one for me. You are the only one who can listen to me. You are the only one who knows me. And it's like the girl was getting very, very comfortable with the whole thing. And like, this guy cannot go a day without talking to this girl. So the guy was like, okay, this is it. This is my guy. She started thinking about the other way. Like, okay, yep. Next one is...
The next step is marriage.
Marriage. He's going to propose anytime soon. And one time, I think, if I remember very well, the guy have invited her very out late. And then they went out. She was thinking something would happen. It didn't happen. But still in her mind...
She was thinking what would happen.
Or that like the guy was proposed or something, but it didn't happen. Uh-huh. So... She was okay. I mean, but still knows that this is my guy. Only for one day the guy to call her and say, guess what? I think I really find the lady that I'm looking for.
Yehovah.
The girl was like, what did you say? It's like, I think I met the girl, like, oh, you would not believe it. She's like this, she's like that. She really had to hang up the phone and call the guy back. Say, okay, I'll call you back. That she was not sure like what she was hearing. It was so bad, it took her 3.5 years. She had to relocate from Chicago, the cold place, Chicago, to New Jersey. And the girl name was Jessica. So when she called in, actually I was so hurt for her. Like, oh my gosh, this is very painful.
Yeah.
And like, it took her 3.5 years to get over it, to like let it go. So I was telling Lindsay, and Lindsay was like, oh yeah, mommy, there's a lot of that going around. And I was like, this is very painful because this is not the worldly people, this is Christians. I mean, she's in the church with this person, is a born again believer, she's a born again believer. And if you are in the Lord and you're gonna go through this, like, hello, I don't know what I would do if it's me. Like, be with somebody for all this time, night, rain, shine, but in your mind, this is my boo, as Americans would say. But then,
my boo bang, it's my bae.
And then for the guy to know that, you know, but the guy was like, but I didn't tell you that I'm in love with you or anything. I told you I'm my friend and we can talk about anything. And the girl was like, it's okay. So
she ended up telling him how she felt.
Yes, she said, you know that I love you and I'll do anything for you. And why did you tell me that I am the only one for you? It's like, yeah, because you are the one who listens to me. Like,
oh,
really?
So yeah, it's like,
so in a way, it's like the guy had totally different thinking about their relationship,
yeah.
And the girl also was thinking about totally different thing about their relationship. And I think as a Christian, I was like, Lindsay, I think Christians, we the mothers have to educate our children, either it's girls or boys, for them to know whether, because it's a Christian brother and always trying to be nice and stuff, don't jump into conclusion, yeah. Because what you're thinking might not be what he's thinking. So that was the little story that...
Okay, so from that story, I was like, you know what? Before we make this video, I need to do a poll on Instagram because I need to see what my followers is thinking and, you know, get their perspective on things. So what I did was I created three scenarios. You don't have to keep smelling. Camera, you can be looking at me. So I created three scenarios of what might be situationships, right? And then I posted it and then people basically responded and said, yes, I think this is a situationship, or no, I don't think this is a situationship. Is this a situationship? Why is this a situationship?
Because she knows how the guy felt about her. Drop everything. I mean, it's just clear that she was into something more than what the guy was into. So, for
he
her,
was into more.
I mean,
the guy was.
Sorry, yeah, the guy was more into Leah than what Leah was thinking. Because if James can drop everything, like, mm-hmm. Hey, Leah, you need me, this is me. And you can tell if he was the action guy, he did so much for Leah to know that, girl, you are my baby.
Yeah.
So I think that is a situationship.
Okay.
I will agree with somebody saying that she was taking advantage of the guy.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes, you know what, let me use this funny thing, like sometimes you just need a dollar and you know, oh, I don't have it, but if I go to James, I'll get it. Mm. So she was really taking advantage,
so
but I don't think she... Convenience, yes, but I don't think a witch is a girl to her.
Washeda, she knows what she's doing.
Shedda, washeda. So baby, remember, I'm hugging, you have to shed a little bit.
Do you think that this is a situation?
It is a situation.
Why?
If I can spend a night at your place,
mm-hmm.
If you can open your mouth to say, I think you are the only one that really listens to me, mm-hmm. you go out and people can see that it's not like only on one side,
mm-hmm.
But they can see that both of you, like, something is going. You know, you see some people, you think they are couples, but meanwhile, they are not couples. But outside, everybody's thinking that something is going on. So that is what it is. So the actions is already proven to people out there that something is going on. And now you, the guy, is telling me that we are chilling. Chilling what? What are we chilling? No.
Are they saying that they feel like she's putting herself in that position because he's already said, we're chilling, we're just vibing. And if she knows that she wants more than chilling, like if she's told herself that, oh, he's into me, but we're just taking it slow, then she's telling herself a lie, basically, that eventually they will advance to a relationship.
What if people outside, because when you were reading before, mm-hmm. You said people can see the spike in them when they go out. Mm-hmm. So if she was doing that to herself, they won't see it between the two.
Mm-hmm.
They will see it from her side. And you know, sometimes you see two couples, let me use couples, or two, and you say, hey, this woman really loves this man. Or this man really, and it's on a real occasion, you see that, hey, they love each other. So for them to see both spiking, both of them, she was not doing that to herself.
That's good. Okay, mommy. Okay, look at you.
No, I mean, am I making sense?
Yeah, it makes perfect sense. Okay, so now, mommy, have you ever found yourself in a situation?
Well, I am too hard to do that.
scared too, what?
My hand is too strong. I don't do that.
No, no challenge. I know I can break your heart.
No. I'm sorry, no.
Is this a situationship?
It's not a situationship.
Why not?
Because you keep telling the person how you feel and the person is telling you, you know, I have a fiancé or I have somebody I'm going out with. It's not a situationship because the person has been very upfront with you. Mm-hmm. So you should understand that. And you guess what? Sometimes people like people. Don't get me wrong.
Okay.
People and get like people. Yes. So I know, and maybe I'll be a little bit wrong, but I might not be wrong, like what I just explained to you. I know you have somebody going out, but we are good friends. The fact that you have somebody going out doesn't mean I cannot be your friend. Okay, so this guy have make it point blank. Oh, I have a fiancé, but I still like you as a friend. And maybe even the fiancé know her that you are friends. That should be okay. So she should not have think that maybe along the line something will change. So,
but if a situationship can be that one person is essentially in a relationship by themselves, isn't Imani in this case in the situation?
And I think situationship is when the other person really don't know.
Okay.
Okay.
But he's identified.
The two of us are doing something. I know this, you don't know. And then later on it tends to be something different. But that's what the person is constantly telling you. That if you ask me and I keep saying I have a fiancé, that means I am not ready to change that situation. So you shouldn't flatter yourself thinking that.
So that don't flatter yourself.
No, like, oh, maybe I'm gonna keep pushing and Monday now.
Okay.
So that is not. And that if somebody used something like she did that to herself, I will agree. Okay. Because the person has been upfront with you.
So someone said that it's not really a situationship, but he's playing games. That he's entertaining someone even though he belongs to someone else. And that in the end, Imani is going to get herself hurt by building a stronger connection with someone that will soon marry another individual.
That's why she doesn't have to do that. Because the person is telling you. And even if later on the person turn around, know that one day the person can disappoint you because she would take your weakness, your leniency to be your weakness. I don't know how to make it. So I think, no. She shouldn't do that. Just pack and go.
Pack and go.
Pack and go.
Okay, so that's we're coming to the end. It's been great. Mommy, have you enjoyed being on my channel?
Well, I have enjoyed being on this channel. Hi, Lindsay fans.
Subscribers.
Oh, sign in promo.
Yes. So, do you think it's common for Christians to find themselves in situationships?
I think it is because, you know, Christians, we are not like, I would say worldly people because we all live in the world, but unbelievers.
We're separated, yeah.
Right, okay. So it's like you are a Christian, you want to do all the right things, you want to meet somebody the right way, you want to get married the right way, you want to do everything God's way. And then you've been in the church after a year or a year and a half, and then all of a sudden this guy start getting closer. And mostly women start praying for partners earlier than men. So that is how the little, since I became born again, the little that I have noticed. So it's like the moment somebody start getting closer in a way, oh my God, my prayers are being answered. And so mostly Christians, as soon as they get one person in the net, they want to protect it, they want to do everything. And then just for you to come and tell me like Jessica that, oh Jessica, I found the right person. Oh no.
Oh hell no.
Oh no, that's not gonna be good. So yeah, Christians, we do find ourselves in that a lot. And that's why I said earlier, that mothers, we really have to educate our children for so that they don't fall into that.
And you know, I think that's a conversation that a lot of African parents don't have with their kids. Like when it comes to dating and, you know, trying to find the right person and all of that.
That is so true.
I think if more of those conversations were had, then a lot of mistakes
would be avoided. Yeah.
Someone, when I asked, do you think that situationships are fairly common in amongst Christians? Someone also said, yes, because Christians are confused human beings. Do you believe this?
I don't believe that. We are not confused. As I said,
come on, somebody.
We are not confused, but it's just because you are waiting for Mr. Right. it's time for you to get married, or it's almost time for you to get married. Mr. Right came in, you're like, okay, here I go. Kwajo is here, I'm grabbing Kwajo. And then you're praying about Kwajo, and then before you know, it's not what you think. Yeah. So I don't think we are confused. It's just because the men. No, we are never confused. But some of them are not straightforward. So maybe they are confused.
The men.
Because they don't know what they want.
Okay, and then lastly, someone said, Christians love to say that they are waiting to hear a confirmation from the Lord, but instead of actually waiting and putting the person on watch and praying about it, they continue to go ahead with the relationship. Instead of putting their feelings on hold, they act on it and end up in situationships, but try to act like it's nothing. They're just my sis, or they're just my brother in Christ. You know you're lying.
That thing I really also don't get is because it's like, it's my sister in Christ. Okay, then back off, let somebody come. If you're a sister in Christ, and sometimes they become overprotective. Mm. They think you're, oh, this is my sister in Christ. Meanwhile, when somebody is coming, they want to weigh the person, judge the person. Who make you Jesus? Mm. Okay, so I think that is what it is. Mm. It's not like, it's not just praying about the situation and holding your feelings, but it's just, they don't move it, let it go the right way. Okay. So I think that is my thinking. Okay. Because you are not my brother, you are my brother in Christ, but
you don't
can
also
do too
be
much.
My husband.
Exactly. Because your mother gave birth to you, I wasn't there. You are not part of my family. So if you know you really, really want to be a brother in Christ, then back up a little bit. Let somebody take the lead. Yeah.
Okay. All right, last one, mommy. So, how can someone identify if they're in a situationship?
Hey!
Like, how can you tell, like, is this a situationship or, you know, and if you identify, how can you get out of it?
This is a very tough question. Why I say that? Because everybody is different. And everybody sees things in a different way.
That's true.
So, it's going to be very hard for me to say, but I would say from my point of view, mm-hmm. if you are a friend, we can do everything together. I'm using me.
Mm-hmm. Everything like what?
Everything. Like, we can go to the movies, we can go out to eat, we can talk, we can stay on the phone. I'm not married, you are not married, and maybe in my mind, I'm thinking that, oh, this is gonna get somewhere. I'll pay attention to so many things, and I think I'll come to you clear. Like, one of the questions you read, I think the third one, if I come to you, I'm like, where do you think this is going? Are we just being friends? Are we just being brother and a sister? Because I have maybe a friend that I think is more interested, so that I don't get myself into that situationship. Okay, so if it's me, I'll see the signs and I'll back off as quick as I can before I get a broken heart.
Come on, that's good. Okay. Mommy, guess what?
What, honey, baby?
We finished.
Yay!
Say bye!
Bye!
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see more of Mama Vida, just hit that comment button. Let me know. Like this video, subscribe, share it. Let us know your thoughts on Instagram. You can send me an email if you want. But yeah, I hope this video blessed you. I hope you learned something. And if you're in a situationship, my friend, run, okay? Love you guys. Bye.